Hello and welcome to T-Mobile G1 Apps. Today we're going to be reviewing a lot of themes today. It's a battle of themes. So, theme battle today. See ya. According to you, hey guys, and welcome to T-Mobile G1 Apps. So, today is battle of themes. Should we use the stock Android theme? How smooth it is. It's just so smooth. Of course, it's gonna be smooth. I mean, it's just very smooth. You can add it to see it looks just like that. Or, should we do other themes? Well, in this review, we're gonna be comparing themes and reviewing themes so you can find the best theme for your Android device. The first thing we're going to try out is 91 iHome. Type in iHome for short. That will take a little bit to load on the first try. So I just downloaded it again. So, quick start guide. Did you a quick start guide? Just redo it. Okay. So here's what it looks like. It's like an iPhone. iPhone light. You move widgets around, but it's really choppy, and it just gets on my nerves sometimes. It frustrates me, and so like, look how unsmooth it is. Sometimes it doesn't even read your text. It's weird. The pluses on this is the theme layout. I like how the clock is and the search bar. The search bar looks very fantastic. I just like how it's very cool looking like that. And then the clock, I like it. It looks like a T-Mobile Pulse clock. Then you have like this dock at the bottom of it right here. Kind of like the iPhone, except for the green. It's not themed like the iPhone. It's way not themed like the iPhone. Takes you to all the stock Android stuff, so nothing new with different customization. So, now let's go to Fresh Face. You know all this thing. This one offers only 5 home screens, and I can. It's alright. I like the music widget because it has a back button and forward button. So like, I'm gonna play it. I can go back and restart it. Go to the last one. Back. But look, if you notice, it says Sweet Dreams right there. And I let go, it goes to Chris Allen. See? Which I don't like. Same thing if I use the trackball for some things like that. See? How it's just doing that? I'm not even clicking anything, it's just highlighting it. That dial works. See? That gets on my nose, and I just don't like it that much. And it's just really unresponsive, but if you get used to that, it's just you. But it just gets on my nose, the outline, and ugh, gets on my nose. The next thing we want to view today is, let me charge my phone here. I'm sorry guys, I'm sorry. But my phone's about to die, and I can't let you die in the middle of the view. So, okay. So, let's go to something called Advanced Launcher. Advanced Launcher is just like the Home Launcher, except you get up to 5 home screens. Hold on. Game time mode. Okay. 5 home. You get up to 12 home screens, but I have 5. Because it's cool like that. It looks exactly like Android stock browser. But what's really cool, like, if I don't like this theme right here, like, let's say I'm going to uninstall iHome, just go to trash room like that, says, gives me options for, like, hide from launcher or uninstall iHome. All I have to do is just click that and click OK. It'll take me to uninstall application, I click OK, it's uninstalling, OK. Now I'm done with that. Taking me back to the home screen. And let's say I want to go to, like, let's say I want Fresh Face to be hid from the store. You just drag it there, it'll say hide from launcher, okay. Now it gives me that saying it's hid from launcher. Look, no more Fresh Face anymore, no more Fresh Face. If I want to get back to it, I just go to more, extended, menu, more extended, app drawer, gives me all the things that I've blocked out. Do that, add back to app drawer. And what's really cool is that I can orientate it like that. It'll match it. I don't even have to have my keyboard split up for it to do that. So I can orientate it and it works smoothly. That's why I really love this thing. This advanced launcher. It's called advanced launcher. They have advanced launcher plus, I believe. And it's just really smooth. It feels like the stock Android browser, except with more than 300 things if you want. If you want to set up home screen, just click menu, go to more, then go to extended. Tap home screen and it gives you this little thing. You have up to 10 home screens, but I have 5. So I can have up to 10 if I wanted to. And then just my trackball here. Go back to 5. I can set what my home default home screen is gonna be. And I can close, start, whatever, tray, whatever. So yeah. It's very good. I recommend Advanced Launcher to everybody, and Advanced Launcher does win this battle because of the smoothness. The smoothness on iHome, it just got on my nerves. The smoothness on FreshBase was okay. It's better than iPhone smoothness. iHome smoothness, but it's just not working out. So, everything's just very smooth on this. If you don't like stock Android browser, go with FreshBase. If you don't like stock Android home, don't go to FreshBase. If you like iPhone thing, go with iHome. I'm just personally saying go with Advanced Launcher if you want more than 3 home screens and you like the regular Android browser and smoothness of it. I mean, it's fast too. It doesn't take a second to load as soon as I get to it. Home button, no. So I'm going to use that as my default, so it's just very nice. It has so much features in it, and it has a lot of potential. So thank you for watching. Remember, Advanced Launcher. Thank you for watching, and talk to y'all later. Bye.